You can't choose your family, but you can find out who they were.
This might be a distant relative.
Families are fascinating.
Wow.
And they're full of secrets and surprises. And there's no such thing as an ordinary family.
I'm not a kid.
Where did I get the genetics to enable me to run fast?
A new series of Who Do You Think You Are starts with Barbara Windsor.
I wouldn't have wanted to be on the rich side at all, because then I wouldn't be me, would I?
Wednesday at 9 on BBC One.
Because you can't be together all the time, Me Too shows your little ones you're thinking of them, even when you're apart. A new series from CBeebies, bringing you together when you're apart. Weekdays at 9 or 5 on CBeebies.
Now on BBC One, he's the consumer champ, he's the scambuster, and he's back.
Hello, and welcome to Rogue Traders. I'm Matt Allwright, and this is Dan.
Here comes the sun.
Since the dawn of time, we have worshipped the sun.
Good day, sunshine.
Now, thanks to solar energy, more of us are beginning to appreciate the financial savings to be made thanks to the sun.
You know the sky. The sky's in love with you.
Unfortunately, some people are using the opportunity to cash in, making their customers glittering promises they can't possibly fulfil.
The sun always shines on TV.
Tonight, we leave no stone unturned.
Oops, not good. Oi, Matt, leg it!
Tonight, on a shiny new series of Rogue Traders, meet two of my new alter egos, Eco Warrior Bob and Wash and Go Joe.
Just a little bit of business outstanding.
Question: how do you know when to walk away from a deal? Answer: when the salesman says,
I want you to have this system free.
Oh, so you want us to have it for free? Because here's somebody who paid for it and got nothing.
Barry. Do you remember Barry?
Yes, he does.
Oh my word, I don't like the look of that. All in the next half hour.
Got to move back up again then.
Yes, Matt. I use the cunning system of levers.
Well, that solved that one.
Yeah.
Solar panels, mate.
What about it?
They can save you money.
That's good.
But they cost you money.
That's not good. I'm confused now.
Well, I think we need an expert, don't you?
Yep.
People who know their solar can be hard to find because A, it's quite a new industry, and B, they're often up on roofs.
I'm here to meet Gareth. He's very high up in the Solar Trade Association. Gareth, how hot is the solar industry right now?
Matt, it's hot and it's getting hotter. There's terrific interest, people being concerned about fuel prices going up, but also because the government's making grants available now. So there is a lot of interest in the solar industry.
Okay, so if you're an unscrupulous salesman, and then you're trying to twist my arm as a customer, how are you going to do it?
Well, it'd be very easy to do that because people aren't really familiar with how these systems work, and you would just go about making sort of exaggerated claims about the savings and how much gas you're going to save and so on.
How much could I be saving for an average house every year, and how much will the unit cost to install?
How much you save is going to depend on the fuel that you're using at the moment, but if you're on gas, I would say somewhere between £50 and £150, depending on how much hot water you're using. And obviously with gas prices going up, that's going to increase. And if you're on other fuels, you might be paying more than that already. In terms of the investment that you'll make, a solar system completely installed would be anything from about £2,500 for a retrofit system up to about £3,500-£4,000.
How on earth am I supposed to get down from here?
Well, Matt, there's a safe way down and there's a quick way down, but I don't think there's a safe quick way down.
Now, you see that, Dan, with somebody that knows about solar panels. Now we need to meet someone that knows
nothing whatsoever about solar.
Sure, mate.
His name is Barry Hillier. He lives in Wiltshire, a stone's throw from Stonehenge. The reason he knows nothing about solar energy is because he hasn't got solar panels on his roof, despite handing thousands to a rep from a company called Sky Energy.
Come on, little fella.
Oh, look at that one. Is that a milker?
You have a job.
Let's see this, look.
Put your hand over the wings. Yeah. That's it, so he don't do himself any mischief.
See that, look.
Well, that's it, that'll do.
Chicks love the leather.
We got mail shotted, you see, about three or four times about solar panels, and we thought we'd do a pricing exercise, see if we could afford it.
So you replied to the mail shot, then what?
They arranged for this chap to come and see us, and he did, and he gave us a price of $13,600, which blew it straight out of the water.
I was going to say, it's not a massive house.
No.
For 13 grand's worth of heating, really.
And a little while later, I can't remember exactly, a month or so, the same fellow that came to see us rang us up and that we could have it for $4,600, but I said, can I pay you a deposit? And he said, no, we couldn't, because of the small amount. We had to pay it all up front.
You sign the cheques, they get cash. Do you remember the name of the salesman?
Yes, Mr. Robert Bray.
Okay.
From Shipton Bellinger.
Would you like us to try and find them for you?
Yes, of course I would, yeah.
Well, we'll see what we can do. Shocking business, Dansky.
What's happened?
Let's just get on the road. I'll tell you all about it.
The somewhat disturbing news is that the rep that took Barry's 4,600 is still in the solar business, working for a company called Solarbank.
Now, we've got information that Robert Bray is now operating in this sun-dappled corner of South Buckinghamshire. So we've got this house, which is not ideal for solar panels.
You see, the roof faces east and west, but not south.
And that means it's ideal for us. It's essential that we see everything that Bob has got to say. That's why this room is full of cameras. There's one right there.
Ooh, hello. There.
And then this one.
Our householder is actress Patricia. I'll be in her ear as she lines up our chance to reintroduce Robert Bray to Barry Hillier, who with Gareth lies in wait upstairs.
Gareth, I need you to tell me when Bob Bray is straying from the path of righteousness, if he's telling untruths, anything like that. Barry, I need you to watch and tell me how what you're seeing compares to what happens to you. Headphones on.
When Robert Bray sits in this chair to sell to Patricia, will he still be the solar energy prince of darkness or an honest little sunbeam?
That's him. And we've got our man. That's Robert Bray. Bob.
When you're retired, you tend to be on a fixed income, don't you?
Yes.
Roughly.
Barry's pleased to see him.
I was just coming through to strangle him.
In a funny way.
We'll actually give you some money towards the
really?
To do.
Really?
Yeah, they will.
Yeah.
We arrange it.
Gosh,
It's from the Department of Trade and Industry, and it's under their Clear Skies programme.
Oh.
The money for Clear Skies has run out beginning this month. So, that's just wrong. Player wrong, yeah.
Good gracious, yeah. Oh, well, that's good.
And not just houses, also factories and
commercial buildings.
We'll have to have a solar system fitted.
Yes.
Or they won't get consent. Wimpy Homes, that you've probably heard of.
Yes,
they're already doing it.
Bullshit. Sorry, that's complete bullshit. Okay.
What happens in the winter about this?
Well, exactly. The flat panels won't work very well in the winter because there's no sunlight.
Oh.
The grant-aided one, which is this one,
yes.
Will work all the year round. So
it's being very misleading by implying this works in winter and the other one doesn't. Okay, that's complete nonsense.
Because of how your house is set up, in that you've got all the things in the right places, as it were.
Is this? Has our house got a good roof for solar power?
No, it wouldn't be a good demonstration of solar power.
It will be very, very efficient, and it will probably reduce your bill by about 63%.
Good gracious.
You could look forward to savings of between, you know, 500 to 630.
Somewhere in between. God.
It's completely ridiculous. £1,000 is your gas and your electricity. For a typical house.
Yes.
He's saying you're going to save all your gas and a bit of your electricity with it, in effect. That's complete nonsense.
Now, the actual cost net to what it would actually cost you is actually £10,150.
How much did they quote you at first?
£13,006.
Okay.
I want you to have this system free.
What do you mean, free?
Right.
£10,000. If monitored.
Yeah, if you monitor it, it will actually fit it for you. We'll actually fit it for you for £6,900.
That's at least twice what you'd pay for a vacuum tube system. It's actually more than that.
Let me frighten you now. And I'm not doing it to frighten you, but...
I don't want to be frightened.
We've worked out, if it only goes up at 10% per annum...
Yeah.
And it's already gone up 30, but...
Really?
10% per annum.
Yeah. How much would that be?
Nearly £26,000.
Oh, my goodness.
He's just misleading her by implying it's going to make that huge saving on her total energy bill. Has he got it on his own house?
Do you have that? Do you have
it
yourself?
I've got the system. Yeah, it's fantastic. Yeah, my boiler, do you know my boiler?
Yeah.
Doesn't fire. My house isn't as big as yours, by the way.
No.
Oh, I'm not. Hello, mate.
Tansky, can you go to Shipton Bellinger in Hampshire and check Bray's house for solar panels, please?
Yeah, no problem. Shipton Bellinger. What the hell is that?
My boiler doesn't work from April right through to September. It doesn't... Don't hear it. Doesn't really? Go on. Yeah.
No solar panels.
Our managing director he's a lay minister.
Oh, really?
We
don't tell any fibs.
Well, you have to have a bit of trust.
Oh, right. Yeah,
you see, the thing is...
I've been trusting that bastard since 2004. Didn't wake up me.
Anyhow, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
That's all right.
You're most welcome.
Okay,
having established that Bob Bray is the David Blaine of endurance fibbing, it's time to pull him out of the water and wake him up.
Let's go. Let's go meet Bob.
Thank you for having us round.
Yes. I'll be in touch then.
Give me a ring tonight.
Well, I'm quite good, really.
Bob, how you doing?
How you doing? You all right?
Yeah, nice to meet you. Matt, all right, from BBC Rogue Traders. How you doing?
Good, thanks.
Great performance. Yeah. We really loved it. A lot of it not strictly factual, though, in terms of the 63% saving for your overall energy bill. Our expert thinks that's way off the mark. Also, the sum of £10,000 for a solar system is, he reckons, at least double. It should be more like £3,000 or £4,000.
Well, I don't make the prices. You need to talk to people I work for.
Well, you know what, I tell you what, I'd love to talk to you, and so would Barry. Do you remember Barry?
Yes, he does.
Barry, you remember Barry Hillier? You took £4,600 off him. You've got some things you'd like to say to Robert, haven't you? What would you like to say to him, Barry?
You took £4,600 off a pensioner for a solar heating system that we never got.
So that's £4,600 from a pensioner for a central heating system he didn't get. How can you explain that, Bob?
The company I work for should have fitted it. It was called Sky.
You were a director of that company, Robert. No, I wasn't. You were a director of that company at the time when you took that money from Barry, who you can't even look in the face right now. But we can see your face, and so can everybody.
Barry, I will talk to you about it, but obviously not in these circumstances.
Why could you not speak to him at the time when he needed your... So he will talk to you, but not in these circumstances. Yeah. See you, Bob. Give him a wave, Barry.
Didn't that just show you what a rascal he is?
Ah, yes. But as ragged rascals run round rocks, so Bob Bray had just run straight into a concrete mixer blocking the lane. It's almost as if we planned it, but we didn't. He was stuck. The perfect chance to get a handle on where Barry's money has gone.
I was told by Tom Murphy...
Remember the name, Tom Murphy.
Sky Energy. But you were a director of that firm. So you should know.
I was only with them for 3 months.
You were a director. You were a director of that firm at that time. Okay, what are you going to do for Barry?
I'm going to contact Tom Murphy now to find out why you haven't had your money back.
You're the one that dealt with him face to face and took those checks from him.
Yes, I did. You took my pension, pal.
Well, but I would make sure, one way or the other, you are repaid. 4,600, if I remember, wasn't it?
4,600.
Yeah, okay. I'll do that, Matt. You have my word. That will be sorted out. Okay.
Mr. Bray later told us he'd never deliberately misled or scared anyone.
What do you mean for that? Bullshit.
He only used facts the company gave him, and he'd never had any of Barry's money.
He did say you were going to get your money back.
I think the other bit was bullshit.
Solar Bank say they don't condone Mr. Bray's actions and will investigate all complaints. They say their prices are similar to other proactive solar companies.
Yeah, I think you had the point, but Bray was talking a lot of merda de vaca.
What's happened to your faith in human nature? Come on, we're going to have a look at another company.
And that company is Smart Energy, the biggest solar company in the country, with the most complaints on our database. Complaints which focus on the way they sell. To find out why, we need another old house and another old Patricia. Why old? Well, because solar silvers, as I've just decided to call them, have the least to gain from a long-term investment in solar heating. Simply, they're less likely to be here in the long term. Time for a change into one of my alter egos. This series, we've got three generations of secret weapon ready to confuse Rogus Britannicus. Stan, Bob, and Joe. All of them just me with bits stuck on. The first one out of the box is Eco Warrior Bob.
Don't say that, you stupid solar panels.
He's a lover of natural energy, a hater of soap and haircuts, and he's greener than Kermit wearing a Celtic shirt. Personally, he quite disturbs me.
My name is Bob. I take and have an interest in all things ecological, psychological, and dermatological.
I will go in as Bob only if the man from Smart Energy talks rubbish to sell 77-year-old Patricia solar which doesn't make financial sense. And when I use the code phrase, Sweet Fanny Adams, the cameras come in too. In the garage down the side, our expert Gareth and I are going to be watching and listening to everything. Again, I'll be in Patricia's ear.
Okay.
As she talks to Mark Riley from Smart Energy. Let's see what he's made of.
Hello.
Miss Roberts, hello.
If you'd like to sit down there, this is my chair.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Well, how does it work?
Right, excellent. Right, okay. It's ultraviolet light radiation. It's got nothing to do with the heat of the sun.
Oh.
Now, what happens? Six, 7 months a year, your boiler completely switched off. That's during the summer months. The only thing that stops it is rain.
He's just contradicting himself then.
In what way?
Well, he's saying it's going to be switched off for the whole summer. Well, it's not, is it? Because he said when it rains, it's not working. He's also overemphasising this thing about UV light, and it's not sunlight, it's UV light now that makes them work. Well, that's nonsense.
We've completely run out of gas.
We've run out of gas. Is there any truth in that?
No, not at all. I mean, we are starting to import gas, but, you know, 90% of it's coming from the North Sea still.
And he's using it to get us scared.
Yes.
Out of your gas bill over the year, what do you think takes up a bigger chunk of the bill? Do you think it's your central heating or do you think it's your hot water?
Oh, I think it's the central heating, isn't it? Yeah.
It's your hot water bill.
Is it?
That's rubbish. Your typical household, yeah, then space heating would be the biggest demand for you know, a conventional house.
But with somebody living on their own?
Well, even more so. It would be the central heating biggest by a long way.
What solar will do out throughout the year is to provide 70% of your hot water.
Huh?
6 months, 100%, allowing for diabolical for winter.
Yeah.
70%.
Yeah.
What this will do is to eliminate 50 to 60% of your gas bill.
Whether it's 50 to 60% of your gas bill is not certainly not in a typical situation, not in her situation.
Because your bills are doubling every 4 years.
More scare tactics.
Yeah, I think you'd have to call it that.
40%, yes,
so
that's
right. You're about a grand, you're all that long in.
So that's 400, yes.
As we sit here.
Yeah.
Is 40% a realistic figure for her place, for this woman?
For all her energy bills?
Yes.
Yeah. No.
It's 40%
of the total.
Of the total, that's the gas and the electricity together.
I mean, less than 20%.
Right.
Of her overall energy bills, including the electricity.
We very nearly went on to 3-day working week, as you probably know, in February.
Yeah.
What you're going to find this winter, the situation we improved it. If we have a cold winter, there's a likelihood we'll have done a 3-day working week.
Scare tactics, isn't it? He's really putting her under pressure. Actually, to sort of have somebody in their own home and actually be putting pressure on them like that, with these kind of tactics, it's taking it too far.
Right, The list price for this, if it's not to the marketing price, is £9,320.
That's the list price.
What do you make of that, Karen?
It's just outrageous.
To get to the marketing one, we knock 5 months off this.
These are a list of price reductions to make you think you've got a good deal.
How much?
233. 8 weeks, we give you £460. Born after, £233. Prominent site subsidies, £233 for that.
She's getting another bonus because this is a prominent site. But right. There's lots of passing trade.
We are in the middle of the countryside.
Yeah.
Some line figure, which is a marketing one, is 6990.
6,990.
6990. Still outrageous. There's no way that you'd want to pay that much for a solar system. You'd be aiming to pay ideally less than half that, and if you shop around, you should get a good working system that will perform as good as any.
Do you think that this system's being missold?
I think without doubt. She's been asked to pay over twice what she would pay if she shopped around. And he's telling her that she's going to be saving 40% of all her energy bills, electricity and gas. It's outrageous. I mean,
and then you add to that scare tactics of saying that gas is running out.
He's just putting pressure on her. He's really trying to scare her into signing that cheque.
Watch those screens, Gareth, because you're going to see me in a minute.
Here I come as Bob, and I'm looking out for my Auntie Patricia. Hello,
nice she's my nephew, actually.
Hello, nice to see you.
Does quite a lot of things for me.
You've got to watch out, though, because it's not cheap, is it? These solar panels, are they? How much is it?
6,990.
You've got to work out exactly how long it's going to take, though. That's the thing, isn't it? Because if you're saving, what, £400 a year... Then how long is it going to take to pay for that, what it takes to pay for the thing on the roof?
The thing with these systems is they last for
30 years. So the next 30 years you're knocking a big chunk off bills. From that point of view, that's how it works.
So that's what? 107 you have to be. Why don't you look sweet family?
What?
Why don't you sweet family? That's for a start. That's the last job I'd want.
With no rivals? The cabinet is extremely good. And we don't actually what we actually say we're going to do from that point of view.
See, I would beg to differ, Mark. Like, all right, BBC Road Traders.
Right,
OK. I beg to differ because the way you've represented the figures here, which is the most important thing here, which is the savings that Our Lady would make, and the incredible cost, the price that you've put on this system, which is way over the odds. At the list price is one thing, but even at the marketing price, it's at least double what it should be. Then I would say that it's quite an... I wouldn't enjoy that job. It's not a job that I would take at all. I'd find it quite unpleasant. Especially when you're going into the houses of people like Patricia, who are in their late 70s and really have the least to gain, if you imagine, because their
last... Can I thank you very much for your time, and I hope I've given it to you absolutely straight how it is. I've been invited into your house, and that's what I was expecting to see. Nice to meet you.
And you too, Mark.
Thank you. Bye.
Just ask a couple more questions as we go out the door. Because our expert, who knows about these things, has estimated it would take about 50 years at current energy prices to pay off the cost... the highly exaggerated cost of the system. Can you explain to me how you can sell something which could take 50 years to pay off to a woman who's in her late 70s?
Can I thank you very much for your time?
Yeah, you already have. Thank you, Mark.
Goodbye.
Okay, bye-bye. Careful as you go. Mark Riley, Smart Energy. It's worth checking out. We were getting the prominent site bonus for this as well, because this is such a good marketing opportunity here, what with all the passing traffic. Enjoy the countryside, gentlemen.
Until this morning, Smart Energy were trying to get a High Court injunction to stop you seeing this programme. Mark Riley faces disciplinary action for breaching their code of conduct. Smart Energy say it's regrettable and no reflection on the service they provide.
One month, and Barry Hillier still hasn't had his money back from Bob Bray.
I told you he was stocking a lot of carpool.
That's it. There are no good human beings left. Come on, let's finish the job.
Barry paid £4,600 to this man, Robert Bray, to have solar panels fitted. They never arrived. Pressed between a concrete truck and a hard place, Bray said...
I'm going to contact Tom Murphy now.
That's Tom Murphy, the founder and director of Sky Energy. We want to find Tom Murphy, obviously. Here's Sky Energy's address in Somerset.
What's happened to that unit there? Because that's yours.
It is indeed.
And Sky Energy used to be there?
They did, up until last August, I think it was.
OK, and why did they leave?
Well, they said that the unit was too small for them, and they wanted to be bigger, and he did say something about moving to France.
France. Thank you very much for your help.
You're welcome.
We'll see you again.
Thank you.
Lovely tractor.
All right.
Well, yeah, but that's where it ends, Densky, unless we can get back to the office and start digging up some files on Company House.
There is another way. Say hello to my little friend here.
What's that, Dan?
It's an office at the palm of your hand.
Oh, my word. You mean we can access Company's House records right here in the beautiful Somerset countryside?
And you can make phone calls.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Get on to Company's House.
Yeah.
Dan's cyber nous leads us to another address in Somerset. We think it's Murphy's home address in the village of Castle Carey. But if I turn up, he might be wary. So I put on long blonde hairy and become Joe, 22 and Larry. I'm melting in the sun. It's also that I can tease Tom Murphy out to meet Barry Hillier and explain exactly what he did with his pension. We're banking on Tom Murphy having a charitable side. The sort of side that will help a spotty youth in vehicular distress.
Oh, no, but it's a diesel. I don't know what I'm looking for. He might know. What is it? Diesel. Do you know anything about trucks, mate?
No, I have a smutter.
This is just, like, stopped on me. It's like kangarooed. I can't work out what's going on with it.
Sorry if I'm not very mechanically
minded. This is unbelievable, this is.
Not a chance. Maybe I should have turned up in a pickup truck that was solar-powered. Let's try the direct approach.
Tommy, you'll remember Barry Hillier, won't you? Matt Allwright from BBC Rogue Traders. You cashed cheques for £4,600 of his. No, you did. No, you really did. Tom? Do you want to have a go? Yeah, go on, ring the bell, see if he's listened to you, because obviously, you know, you're a customer of his.
Mr. Murphy, I wonder if you'd like to come out and have a word with us. Seems to have gone deaf.
Try through the letterbox, Barry. That sometimes works.
Yeah.
Yeah, make sure it hasn't got a dog.
Okay,
no. Well, no, I think you're entitled to.
Can you hear me, Squire? I really would like to have a word with you if you'd come out and talk to me. To explain to me and my missus where our money's gone.
Sorry, if I can help you, I will. What's all this?
What, would you like to
come in the house, you said, just you.
No, sorry.
I don't even know what I'm talking about, to be honest.
Sky Energy, you'll be familiar with that. Tom, do you remember you were a director of Sky Energy?
No.
You were a director of Sky Energy.
Sorry, no.
Well, Robert Bray says that you cashed the cheques from Barry Hillier.
This is not even my house. I'm not standing here.
You signed... Tom, we think we've got a solution. We think we've got a solution.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
You just come on.
Yeah? Yeah? With the cameras, yeah?
No, Carl.
Why not?
Just come in and sit down here. I don't even know what you're talking about.
So you don't mind if I ask you to put the scissors down first, do you? Okay, come on then.
No, I
want Barry to come too, because it's actually Barry's case.
I don't even know what you're talking about. What?
Okay. We've got complainants who have paid money, like Barry there, for a solar heating system that he never received. Now, Barry there has got a Jeep that's worth about £2,000. Yours, your Freelander that's out, that's got to be worth.
Freelander, it's not mine.
That's not yours.
No. I'm only working, helping somebody.
This house
is... not my home, which it was.
Yeah, this house is actually with the land registry registered to your wife.
Next wife, yeah.
Tom and Mrs. Murphy are still married and living together.
What is the solution and what is the problem?
£4,600 for this man.
I don't have any checks now.
This is
I'm liable for this, but I will get Mr. Liston and look into it. If I am, I'll pay it.
Director
no disrespect Thomas. To you. It's very nice to talk to you. If you want me to, I'll do my best. I'll sort things out for this problem.
It all sounds like a load of codswallop, Tom,
well,
I have to say. Yeah.
We'll be in touch.
Barry, I don't know what to say, because none of it made any sense whatsoever to me. And every time that I came up with something, it contradicted what he'd already told me. Don't hold your breath for your money.
But we never give up. We carried on writing and phoning on Barry's behalf, and 3 months on, I've got some good news for him.
Sorry to leap out like that. Yeah, how are you? You all right?
I'm very well, sir. Lovely to see you.
I've got something for you.
Oh, yes?
See that there? That's a cheque for £4,600.
Oh.
Got your money back.
Fair.
And you want some really good news?
Yes.
Bob Bray's got the sack.
there is a God.
Come on.
Enjoy it.
Does that make you feel good?
It's a great feeling.
I'm very happy. A warning, though. If you're thinking of investing in solar panels, then it could work out being better for your conscience than it is for your pocket. And if you're going into business selling the things...
You better watch it, Sunshine.
See ya.
There's no sunshine when she's gone.
Next week on Rogue Traders, we're on the roof. Nylon Jumper meets Blowtorch in a battle to the death. My mum says keep picking that and it'll fall off. And Stan meets the man who carries the can.
You're not talking to me.
Hey, don't leave Gary here. See you then.
The one to watch tonight.
So all we got to do is find someone with muddy boots who owns a brown dog. Can't be many of those in Yorkshire.
D.L. and Pascoe next on BBC One.
Mum and Dad were that rarest of things, teenage sweetheart. We wanted to find a little way to say thank you for the last 20 years.
Amazing, Dad.
A brand new season of comedy drama kicks off with After Sun, starring Sarah Parrish.
Stop the car!
What's that like? Being married for 20 years.
Magical. Every single moment just magical.
After Sun, new comedy drama, Friday at 9 on BBC One.
The chilling climax to Murder Now on BBC One with D.L. and Pascoe in Dangerous Waters.